नेक्स्ट लेक्चर. इन दिस लेक्चर यू आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट डिज़ाइन क्राइटेरिया एंड कंस्ट्रक्शन डिटेल्स ऑफ ग्रीन हाउस. कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ पाइप फ्रेम्ड ग्रीन हाउसेस. मटेरियल रिक्वायरमेंट. प्रिपरेशन ऑफ मटेरियल्स एंड प्रोसीजर ऑफ इरेक्शन. So points to remember while designing the greenhouse construction. Whenever you want to design a greenhouse, so these points you must consider. First, so you must select a appropriate land, so which is larger than the grower interest, and it must be suitable for the greenhouse cultivation. Like so, it should not have any slope. Then it should be far off from the trees and the surrounding buildings, and electricity water supply must be sufficient. So such land you must select for the greenhouse construction. Next is, so you must select the size and the range of the greenhouse. Then in the greenhouse we should accommodate the service buildings, storage area, access drives and parking lot. So apart from the cultivation and the crop area, we must select or allot some area for the service buildings, storages, access drives and parking lots. Around 10% of the total area of the greenhouse must be allocated for the service buildings. The service buildings are used for the storage of fertilizers, seeds, or storage of the machineries, or we can use it sometimes for the as a godown also. So for all this purpose we will use the service buildings. These are the point one must consider while constructing the greenhouse. And the doors must be wider, so it must be at least 3.1 meter wide and 2.7 meter high, so that so we can take all the machineries and the automobiles, whatever required to the greenhouse, so that so it is viable for all the types of movements. Next, if you see the construction of glass greenhouse, earlier in the 1950 people were referring only glass greenhouse because of its greater interior light intensity. So it provides us a large light large amount of light intensity, so which enhances the air infiltration rate and leads to lesser interior humidity. So if the interior humidity is less, then the disease prevention is easy. So it is one advantage for the disease prevention. So that is why earlier people were going for the glass greenhouses, but due to its cost, so glasses are so huge in cost and maintenance is also difficult, so that later on these were replaced with the plastic films. So but we must consider the recovering costs also. If we use the polythene sheets or polyethylene material, so their durability is less, around 4 to 5 years. Later on you should go for the recovering. But if you use glass greenhouses, that will last long for around 20 to 25 years. So there is a need for recovering would be lessened here. So these consideration also one must consider before selecting the covering material. Next, we have taken a case study of construction of pipe framed greenhouses. In this type of greenhouses, we will use the pipes for the construction, and we will use UV stabilized low density polyethylene films as a covering material. So why we have selected the pipe framed architecture and LDPE films are, so these are low in initial investment, and their life is also little bit longer compared to other considerations. Here the material required are hoops, foundations, lateral supports, poly grip assembly and end frames. So these are the materials required for construction of pipe framed greenhouses. Then we will see how we can erect a greenhouse of 4x20 floor area. So here we have taken a floor area of around 4 meter into 20 meter. So for this 4x20 floor area, so what are the considerations we have to consider, or what are the procedures we have to follow, or what are the materials required for this? So first we want GI pipe of class A and GI pipe of class B. Here class A and class B are classified according to their diameters and length. Then the GI sheets, 20 kg, and size is 19 to 24. So 4 sheets of GI sheets we required here. And GI pipes of class A and class B are 25 millimeter diameter and 15 millimeter in diameter. And next is MS flats, then lateral support end frames, cement concrete in a proper ratio, UV stabilized LDPE film, then poly grip, wooden end frames, nuts and bolts of proper dimensions, then some miscellaneous items like hinges, nails, latches, etc. So these are the material required to construct 4x20 floor area greenhouse. Next, if you see the procedure of erection, first we must select the appropriate dimensioned floor area, that is 20 meter into 4 meters, and we should select the or identify the four corners of this flat. Then from one corner you start and start marking the points at a distance of 1.5 meter. Okay, so at a distance of 1.5 meter, so you will get around 17 points in one side and 17 points on the other side. Totally you will get 34 points. So usually we will orient along the east-west direction to break the wind naturally. Then as I told, so make the points at every point 1.25 meter at a distance. Then dig the hole of 10 centimeter in diameter and 70 centimeter in the depth. So in all the 17 points, dig the hole of 10 centimeter in diameter and 70 centimeter in depth. So then we are going to install the poly grip assembly into that holes. By using some support, we will make them make the poly grip assembly stand, and we will pour the concrete so that So it will be held with some support and we will leave it for the curing. After curing for 2 to 3 days, so these all the polygrip assemblies would be installed. So after the installation of the polygrip assemblies, so we have to attach the end frames. So by using the proper specified bolts and nuts, we will fix the polygrip assemblies. Then we will use the concrete mixture of 1:3:6 ratio. Then after curing, the polygrip assembly would be firmly fitted to the ground level. Then we have to position the end frames. So both the ends, front end and back end frames, are positioned and fitted with the bolts and nuts. Then we will use the hoops. We will connect or fix the hooks by using the hoops by using the bolts and nuts to each polygrip assemblies. So these are called as the end frames, the front end and the back end, and these are the hoops. So each hoops and the end frames are attached, and the hoops and the end frames can be firmly make attached to the polygrip assembly and stand firmly by using the ridge line. So this is called as the center line is called as the ridge line. So to that ridge line we will attach the hoops by using the cross ties and bolts and nuts. So the end frames and hoops are connected to the ridge line by using the cross ties and bolts and nuts. So this ridge line would be around 20 meter in long and 15 millimeter in diameter. So that would be centered, and to that hoops and end frames are connected by using appropriate dimensioned bolts and the nuts. And you repeat this procedure for all the lines, all the hoops. Then after connecting, so then we have to cover the this structure with the covering material. Normally here we are using the LDPE, that is low density polyethylene material. We will fix it to the polygrip assembly, then spread it. First we will connect it to the ridge line, then to other side. So without the wrinkles and without any foldings, we will spread the polyethylene material and we fix it to the end frames and the ridge line, and again then the front covering also covered with the polyethylene material, the front and back side as well as the side posts are also covered with the polyethylene material. So here we must take care while spreading the polyethylene materials, there should be no any wrinkles and the foldings. So first you attach it to one end, then spread it, tight it and connect it to ridge line, then you attach it to the other side. Then we will use the wooden battens and nails to connect this polyethylene material to the hoops and the ridge lines. Here we will use the wooden battens and nails actually. So the remaining portion of the end frames and the side posts are covered or connected with the polyethylene material by using the wooden battens and nails. And after this covering material has been completely covered, then so we will use some, we will attach the mechanical ventilators, heating requirements, cooling requirements, all those things to the greenhouse. So according to our requirement, we will attach the either the FOX system or fan and pad system or the unit heaters or the central heaters. So all those things we will attach to the greenhouse. So that would be a full-fledged greenhouse erection. So here once again, if we have to summarize, means here we will identify the 4 by 20 area. Then for starting from one corner, we will dig a hole of 10 centimeter by 70 centimeter and install the polygrip assemblies. Then to that polygrip assemblies, we will attach end frames and the hoops. And those hoops are made firm by using the ridge line. And to that ridge line, after the ridge line has been connected using the cross ties and the bolts, then we will start spreading the polythene material. Then that polythene material is spreaded without any wrinkles and the folds. First it is connected to the one end of the polygrip assemblies, then the ridge line, then to the other side. So in the examination, then I ask you to write the procedures for erection of a pipe framed greenhouses for 2.5 or for 3 marks, or they may ask it for the 4 marks also. So you should write this diagram and explain it briefly. So what is the material requirement? So what is the procedure? So what is the first step, second step, up to the last step you have to explain.